Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Be Yourself. This is Dr. Nish Sharma, and in my last video I ended my class with this video, with this question which was from the map unit. And my last video I have discussed some questions about of the population genetics which I have taken from the CSIR June 2016, and this time also I have taken the question from the June 2016. So let's see how to solve such questions. The question is that poplar is dioecious plant, a wild plant with three genes, all in the in the homozygous dominant one, was crossed with a triple recessive mutant A, B, and C. The F1 male hybrid in the heterozygous form was then back crossed with the triple mutant, and the phenotype recorded as follows. Now here we have to find out the distance or the map unit between A and B and C gene. So the question is quite simple, is that in our segment we have to, in the segment of a gene of a chromosomes, which we have to find the distance between three genes, which is A, B and C. So another point is that first we have to find out whether the sequence is ABC or it can be also ACB. So before going through the distance or find out the distance between AB and BC, first let's calculate the distance or the sequence of the gene, because if the sequence it is looking quite possible that we have to find find out the distance between A and B and B and C. But what if the gene arrangement will be something like this ACB? Then how we will calculate the distance between A and B and B and C? This time it will be complicated. So not as complicated, because the data it's already provided here. So first let's see how to first find out the sequence of the gene from the given data. So in total, we will add up all this. We will have in total, we have 1000 number of progeny. Now, of this 1000 progeny, the most highest value, which is 300 and 310, is of the parental type, and the having the lowest one, which is the 16 and 14, is having the double crossing over, while the rest are having the single crossing over. Single crossing over between either from in between A or A and B, or between B or C. One crossing over. And about the double crossing over, it is in something like this. If these two segments is undergoing double crossing over, A, uppercase ABC, lowercase ABC, if it is undergoing double crossing over, it means A, this segment has come here and it has taken this segment of lowercase B, and again is having the its own segment of the uppercase C. So we will get the product something like this: A small B capital C, and for this chromosome will inherit this segment of the chromosomes, which is small a capital B and again small c. So now if we have the sequence like ABC, then it's only possible that this middle gene can undergo double crossing over. So now come to the data, which is small a small c, and here is only the middle B, and here it's all here also capital B capital C, and here is the middle we are having the small b. So from the data we can say that yes, the sequence is as it is, as shown as A, B and C, which is B is in the middle of A and C. Now move to the question. Hope you have understood how I have calculated the analyzed the sequence of the gene in the chromosome. And now next question is to calculation of the genetic map. For this, there is a formula, is that map distance is equal to the number of recombinant offspring divided by total number of offspring into 100. Now it's quite simple that if we have a double crossing over, then we it means this has crossed over between the A and B also and B and C. So it will be included in the as a recombinant offspring, whether we will talk for the A to B or we will talk for the B to C. So Now first let's have a look for the distance between A to B. If we have to calculate the distance between A to B, then we have to find out the single cross over taken in between A and B. So look at the data. Other 100, 65, 75 and 120 are the four data of the single crossing over. Here you can see that there is a crossing over between A and B. How? Because instead of capital A, here is small a. So it means that there is a crossing over between A and B, because of which this segment A has shifted to here. Because of this, it has the homologous recessive gene of A followed by its own parental sequence. Now move to the next data. Here too also, we find that there is a crossing over between B and C, because here instead of having the parental sequence, it is having the recessive genes of the of its another parent, which is completely recessive one. Next data, here also there is a crossing over between B and C, because now this time the parental type homozygous recessive one has undergone crossover with the segment the heterozygous one, which is the capital C. So this is a crossing over between B and C, and this one is the parental type, so we will not take it because it's not a recombinant one. We are looking for the recombinant one. Last data is also from the recombination between the other crossing over between A and B, because here the parental type of all the homozygous recessive one has crossed up a segment with that of the capital A of the heterozygous species. So now from here we can say that 100 plus 120 plus these two, the recombinant one, is for the recombination between the A and B. So let's note out all this. 100 plus 120 plus 16 plus 14 by total number of the progeny, which is 1000 divided multiplied by 100. When you will sum up all this, you will get 250 by 1000 into 100. Now when you will calculate this, you will get 25 map unit between A and B. Similarly, between B and C, you will get 65 plus 75 plus 16 plus 14. You will get 60. Distance between B and C will be 65 plus 75 plus 16 plus 14 by 1000 into 100. You will get it as a 17 map unit. I am taking double recombination here, 16 plus 14, 16 plus 14 both, because both the segment you will can see that here is the recombination between B and C also, and A and B also, in case of double crossing over. Okay, so the answer will be 25 and 17 map unit respectively. Hope you have understood this. If you have some similar types of questions and unable to solve it, and then please send me to my email ID I am giving you. Here is rajani.bharatiya@gmail.com, and don't forget to subscribe and share my channel for the updates. And you have also sometimes similar questions or dissimilar questions, please send me through my email ID. If I will able to solve it, I will give it to you. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.